Bismillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. My dear Muslim brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is your brother Abdusalam, AbuHanifa. Sometimes life plays tricks on us, and all this is by the decree and planning of Allah. And an event takes place, and it brings with it more news, more revelations than anything else. And I am referring specifically to the winning of Donald Trump, the presidency of the United States of America. Today, when I woke up in the morning, the very first thing that graced my eyes is a message from a gentleman that says, Donald Trump won the election. Welcome to the Fourth Reich. Just like in the German Hitler Nazi stuff. And then after that, I received a couple of messages from different people. A translated meaning of a hadith where the writer claims that the hour will not come until the worst of you inherits your world. And he says this is a Tirmidhi. Of course, I got annoyed, but I will comment about this in a second. Then a little bit after that, another message was sent by somebody else to double-check what is the authenticity of this, whereby he says, Prophet Muhammad said, when the power or authority comes to the hands of unfit persons, then wait for the final hour. Sahih al-Bukhari 59. All this is in English. Now, if the presidency of Donald Trump winning brings something, it just shows how coward Muslims have become. So, okay, he won the presidency. He's going to be the president. What it is in us that makes us think that he is unfit to rule? Subhanallah. If international politicians, people who understand politics, people who are cut since the day they were born until today into politics, agreed to let Donald Trump run the United States, why should I listen to some Muslim who doesn't even know how to perform Salat judge Donald Trump? The problem is not in Donald Trump. The problem is in this Muslim who has set it himself or herself as an authority, and by that rule that Donald Trump is unfit to be a politician. Subhanallah, does that mean that you, the writer of this, are you fit to run the United States? If you are fit, why isn't your face there in the White House? If this tribulation of the Donald Trump shows something, is how scared Muslims are, how weak their tawheed is. Now, if the election of Donald Trump didn't mean much to you, you are in good terms, mashallah, you are a great person. But if your heart is beating, if you are scared, if, then you must really, really double check your iman. Very first thing. First of all, it is a lie, and he is a liar, or she is a liar. He who has, or she who has, translated the Arabic text into English and lied on behalf of our Prophet, because our Prophet never spoke English. Again, and I say it, and I will say it, and one day you will see the consequences of what Muslims are doing today. Islam is being Christianized, and what I mean by that is, Christianity do not have the original texts, the Aramaic texts, and they are all making up stories, translating here, new version, this, and a yearly review of the Bible. Muslims are doing the same thing. Arabic doesn't exist anymore. How big is a liar of someone that says the Prophet said, and then they went ahead and said it in English? Those who lie on Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and what awaits them is very, very, walayyadu billah, painful. Now let me tell you how Muslims, as a Muslim, how I should welcome what is happening in the world today. And please notice how I said welcome and not getting scared or pee my pants just because Donald Trump is the president of the United States. Now let me tell you something. What is the worst that can happen? If Shaitan was the president of the United States, should I be concerned and afraid of him? Of course not. What is Donald Trump compared to a shaitan? He's nothing. He is nothing. But what these weak iman Muslims today is, they are going to pee their pants just because a human being is in power? Subhanallah. Where is the faith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who runs the world? Where is the belief that Allah is the strong? Where is the belief that Allah, just like He destroyed the predecessors like Thamud and Ad and Fir'aun and all these great nations and the people of Nuh alayhi salam, and can't He just take care of Donald Trump today? Yeah, subhanallah. Okay, let me tell you a couple of things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke in Al-Quran. One day Quraysh hired some people, what are as known today as the media, to go to our Prophet and tell the believers that Quraysh has gathered a huge army and that the Muslims better be afraid because Quraysh is coming to just squash them and walk on them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala eternalized this event in Al-Quran when He said, الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ آل عمران الآية 173. In the translation of this ayah here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about these people who went to the believers and told them the following. People have gathered for you and against you. So be afraid of them. But what did happen? Subhanallah, these scaremongering yielded the opposite of what they were hoping for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا. That threat increased the belief of the mu'mins, of the believers. And what they said, وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَ اللَّهِ. It is sufficient for Allah. We take Him as the one who will defend us, and نِعْمَ الْوَكِيرُ, and it is whom upon we rely. And what a great one to rely upon. So as you can see, it's not Donald Trump, and it's not the EU, and it's not England, and it's not the world. We're talking here about Allah. About Allah. Why is Allah excluded from the equation? It's just because Donald Trump is the president? What is the worst that he can do? Come to your home and kick you in the head? You are already kicking yourself in the head if you are scared just because he is a president now, or that is going to wreak the havoc in the world. Let me tell you something else. If you are scared and if you are concerned because Donald Trump is becoming or has become the president of the United States, then you certainly need to double check your faith. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا ذَلِكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ يُخَوِّفُ أَوْلِيَاءَهُ فَلَا تَخَافُوهُمْ وَخَافُونِي إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. That is only a shaitan who frightens his awliya, i.e. those who are in his party. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not be afraid of them and be afraid of me if you truly were believers. That is the true belief. Donald Trump or not Donald Trump. Let me tell you something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who has appointed Donald Trump the president of the United States. It is Allah that didn't choose Clinton. It is Allah who plans. Do you know something? If Fir'aun had one day known that he would die by chasing the children of Israel, he would never have done it. But his arrogance, his blindness, his superpower, and the silence of Allah that he didn't punish him, that drove him to arrogance, and guess what? Led him to his destruction. Do you think America is headed in the right direction? That is not, subhanAllah, throughout the world, everybody says America is deteriorating, and it is. So why are you scared? What's this all scare about? Let me tell you something else. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defends those who believed. The problem is not Donald Trump, because the promise of Allah to defend the believers is on. The problem is, are you a believer that deserves the defense of Allah? This is a question that we should really, really care about. I don't care what the world will do. If they kill me, they will kill me and I am on my faith and I will go to Jannah. I will go to a God because now I am a pious person. I do not disobey Allah and I do my very best at being the best of who I can be. So if death comes to me, welcome. I'm ready. Now, if you are one of those guys that disobey Allah, not wearing the hijab, working in haram, watching and doing all those things, trading in haram and all these things, guess what? Of course you should be scared because shaitan has got you from where it hurts. Again, these translated hadith, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِذَا وُسِّدَ أَوْ أُسْنِدَ الْأَمْرُ لِغَيْرِ أَهْلِهِ فَانْتَظِرِ السَّاعَةِ. If the matter is given to those people that are unfit, expect the hour because of the chaos. But let me tell you something. Before Donald Trump, how about the king of Saudi Arabia? Are they fit to run a Muslim land? Of course they are not. Any Muslim leader, are they Pakistan, Afghanistan, Bangladesh, North Africa, Libya, Egypt? Who is worse, Donald Trump or Sisi? Which we've got probably no idea what Sisi is doing. It's not about Donald Trump. Look at Muslims, how idiots they are. Donald Trump comes president, the Jews are applauding and celebrating with him, and Muslims are declaring their animosity to him. And then later on, when he kicks them with his boots, we always will wonder, why? What's wrong with us Muslims? Subhanallah al-Haq, my dear Muslim brothers and sisters, these are words from my heart to your heart. What's happened in the United States is nothing else but the decree of Allah. Allah has got plans. Perhaps the kicking of the boots of Donald Trump's on our butts will get us united, will get us back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Perhaps the whip that's going to lash us will get us back to who we truly are. Perhaps when we see the knives that the children of Israel saw by Pharaoh will get us back to Allah. If it takes all that for us so that Muslim people start observing the laws of Allah, then it is welcome. Because sometimes people don't understand by kind words. Sometimes they understand by the stick. Donald Trump, who is Donald Trump? Bring what you got to the table. Before you, so many people declare. Cameron, the Prime Minister of England, didn't he declare war on Islam? He went out of his premiership of England with his tail behind his legs. You don't mess with Allah. He lets you do something for a time, but that doesn't mean eternity. Show me one person in these days, Gaddafi, Saddam Hussein, and many other people. What have they done against Islam? Clinton, Barack Obama. His name is Hussein Barack Obama. Typical Muslim name. What did he do? Nothing for the Muslim. Absolutely nothing. At one day, I remember back in time when Tony Blair came to power, everybody was happy because he is labor and they are better than the conservative. He launched a war against Iraq. He sided with the stupid Bush and caused more trouble to the Muslim world than the conservatives themselves. When will you people stop being weak? When will you people stop being cowards? I am not talking to everyone here. I'm talking to those people that are scared and they keep sending all these wrong messages, scaring the Muslims. Stop scaring the Muslims. You only scare yourself. We absolutely, totally have faith in Allah. Donald Trump is a guy whose heart is between the two fingers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That man is crazy, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala owns his neck. Allah owns him totally. Whatever happens in this earth happens by the command of Allah. Nothing is left to mankind. But to me and to you and to those pious people, we should always, always find comfort in the ayah, Inna Allaha yudafi'u ani alladhina amanu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defends those who believe. So my job, my brothers and my sisters, and your job is that we reach the eligibility level. What is that? Being of the mu'mineen. Don't worry about Donald Trump. That is just another dog on earth. All we have to go and call on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just like for a shaitan. We can't fight a shaitan. The only way to fight a shaitan is أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. And the same thing, these politicians, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spoken about them. إِنَّهُمْ يَكِيدُونَ كَيْدًا. And he didn't say, وَتَكِيدُونَ كَيْدًا. They plot great plots, and he didn't say, and you plot. What did he say? And I, وَأَكِيدُ كَيْدًا. And I plot to them a plot. Allah's plots do not take effect every single second. Allah's plots can take a year, two, 10. Where is now all these people that fought Islam? They gone into the trash of history. Islam moves on. So my brothers and my sisters, stop being a coward. Have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Work on your iman. Strengthen your faith. Work on your behavior. Work on your aqidah. Work on your Quran. Work on your salat. And let and leave Donald Trump to Allah. Allah will take care of him. This is your brother Abdusalam Abu Hanifa. And to join my group, just send me a message with your name to 07876408735. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Certainly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defends those who believe, and I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you and I are of those believers. وصل اللهم على نبينا محمد سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.